In this training video, many of our illustrations use the old version of the template because it is so different from the new version. Once you download and play with the trial of the new version, you are seriously going to want an upgrade. The first thing to notice about the QFD template is that it is huge. Like most systems to win templates, it is designed to give you more working space than you really need. And then you hide the columns and rows that you don't need. To resize the roof of the house to match the exposed columns, you hold down the Shift key as you drag this clever mask. With the new version, you just click this Change Rows and Columns button to change the number of rows or columns. And it automatically resizes the top of the house. In both the old and new versions, you list your voice of the customer demands in this column and your functional requirement performance measures in this row. Notice how you can use these optional category and subcategories to add more clarity and organization to your data. Or if you don't need those category header rows or columns, you can just hide them. And then you use your team's agreed-upon rating system to rate the correlation between each customer demand and each performance measure. Like every Systems to Win template, you can define your own rating system in a green-bordered text box like this. It's common to use a 931 or a 941 rating system just to give a wider spread between the alternatives, but you can use any rating system you like. Notice how if I put a period in a cell, that means that our team has thought about it and decided that there is a zero correlation. But if the cell is blank, that means our team has not yet agreed upon what the correlation should be. If I put a number in a cell, then the cell turns a color that makes the correlation stand out. In this top row, the arrows indicate the desired direction of improvement for each measure. Do we want this measure to go up or do we want it to go down? Or that circle means that the target is best. In the old version, in the upper roof of the house, you copy and paste these simple plus or minus symbols to indicate whether any two performance measures might reinforce each other or conflict with each other. And again, once you download and play with the trial version of the new version, you're very much going to want an upgrade. In the new version, when you click one of these correlation cells, a drop-down will appear that you can use to choose one of the values from your team's agreed-upon rating scale. And the same thing for the desired direction of measure. The QFD template now uses the same convention used by so many other Systems to Win templates to define these drop-downs on the DV worksheet, where you will notice that there are a whole lot more user-defined drop-downs that you can define than we are showing you in this video. And notice that when you select a cell on the roof of the house, not only do you have your user-defined drop-downs, but it also highlights the two columns that have the correlation. Showing you the side-by-side old and new versions of the QFD is a good case illustration of how we're serious about our mission to continuously improve your tools for continuous improvement.